On 20th July 2022, the DP party president Norbert Mao signed a cooperation agreement with the ruling ANRM party. Since its signing, Mao has on several occasions explained this agreement to sections of Ugandans. Today, Mao engaged academicians, university professors, elders, and some of the party National Executive Committee members in Kampala to further explain the cooperation agreement. He noted that the ambition of the agreement is to enable a peaceful and democratic transition of power.
What is at stake is, can we find a formula for governing ourselves without violence and bloodshed? We must break that cycle, and DP has its proposal. It may not be the right one, but at least we have had the courage to say, okay, here it is on the table.
Makerere University professor Julius Kiza, however, disagreed with some of the points in the agreement. He called for an amendment in the cooperation agreement to include the social and economic issues still affecting the public.
It's interesting. All your questions are interesting. But from the honorable, was talking like as if he thinks I'm pushing you too hard. If I'm pushing you hard, it's because I want you to do hard work. Because I think we have too many lazy people in this country. And I think there's a lot of potential in each one of us, which we underutilize. So that's why I'm pushing very hard. Because if the DP, the UPC, no, FTC, NRM, if all the political parties do a good job, we will have a better country. True or false? This will need to go an extra mile.
However, other scholars were in support of Mao, arguing that the agreement would foster development in the country.
How representative else would this have been? The democracy we are talking about now is from Greece. Before that, the whole village will sit and talk for days and days. So representatively, members were consulted. The biggest problem we have in this country is that people play to the gallery. The MP, when the president of the party invited MPs at Hotel Africa, the member of parliament who was given the phone where the agreement was and he read it to the colleagues, went on radio saying, I have never seen it. That is the type of people we have in this country.
In this cooperation agreement, the two political parties agreed to share political power, enable a peaceful and democratic presidential transition, foster constitutionalism, respect for the rule of law and respect human rights, build a new consensus from a national dialogue and reconciliation process, as well as support electoral and constitutional reforms. Report compiled by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.